All right, in this tutorial, I will be showing you how to use the template number one template that has been added into the modules with the iframe engine. So basically what you would do is click template one, starting with a blank page, nothing else on it. And then from here, what you're gonna see on this template is it is set up to have a header, a subtitle, a banner, and then text, and then of course you can do something with the footer. So let me show you how what you would do here. Basically you go click here, you would click select file to select a header image, and I'll do that real quick. Okay, so I selected a header, you can see that here. Now subtitle, you're using the text box and you can put whatever you want in here. So let's just put in test template number one. Now there's a couple things you want to do here. If you leave it here, it's going to be whatever the smaller size, and it's going to be left justified. So since it's a subtitle, I probably want to center it, and then I probably want to make it bigger. So I'm going to make this one pretty big. I'm going to do 48 font. Let's choose Tahoma because Dave seems to love Tahoma. You can change the colors over here if you want to change the text color. We'll make this one, let's make it kind of a orange. And that's what I want to do from there for the subtitle. And then you can upload a banner image also. So let me upload a banner image. So now I've uploaded a banner image. Now keep in mind when you're doing these, you do have some image restrictions. The header can be no wider than 518 pixels. It can be as tall as you want. The banner image, the maximum width is 480 pixels, and it can be as tall as you want. And then here we've got some, the page content. Again, we can add whatever we want here. So I'll add some text here real quick to it. And so just like in the above here, you want to format that text however you want. I like to have things centered because it looks better depending on what you're doing. If you're doing a list or something, obviously you may want paragraphs. If you're doing paragraphs, listing different information about your product, you're probably going to have it differently. But for this case, I'm going to center it. I'm going to change the font. I'm going to put Verdana on this one. Not as big in the font here. I want a 16. And the color, let's make this one kind of a blue. Then you can choose the top spacing and bottom spacing you want. I'm going to leave it where it's at so we can kind of see what it looks like. Once we're done, oh, also, before we're done, a lot of people ask about the footer settings. The footer's going to be right here. Click on the little engine cog, and then you want to change your footer here, iframe engine, and then you can put additional footer text in there if you'd like as well. So let's click save on that. And then we'll also click save on the template. You can click save right here on the template. All right, and then once you hit save, you're going to have your template right here. It's got your image, your banner. I made this orange in the text box. You see how it turns orange in the template, in the subtitle. Got the text here, got your banner image here. And then so what you would do, if you haven't published the page already, you would click publish page right here. And then what it'll do is it'll open up the screen asking for permission to publish this tab. And yes, I want to add the iframe engine tab too. This is the second tab on this page. Using for tutorials here. It'll show it to you live here. And then boom, there it is live. Now granted, see how this image here looks kind of fuzzy? That's because it was only 300 pixels wide. So it did expand it out to 480. So kind of keep that in mind. When you're putting things on, you can see how quick and easy it was to make that template. So there is a tutorial on how to use template number one inside the iframe engine, and look forward to seeing another tutorial. All right, something that I wanted to add about the templates is, as they are, they will have a white background, but you can change the background color of the template. But keep in mind, it will change your text colors and everything that's inside there. So what you would do is you click page styles, and then from here, if you want to change the background color, you would select that here. So let's say I kind of want to make it a bluish color there. I'm just going to do the background color for now. I won't change anything else. And you can see there it changed the background color there of everything. So I'll show you what it looks like live on Facebook. You can see that everything's blue now. And so keep that in mind. You can change that if you want, but once you do that, your text may not look exactly right, so you may want to change your color first And then go in and add the template and then the appropriate color text. So in this case, I'd probably make this a white text if I were to use this, or something that stands out a little bit more. So keep that in mind as you're making your templates, that you don't have to use a white background. You can change the background color to be whatever you would like. Another tip to keep in mind when you're using the templates is you can add a reveal tab to the templates. What you would do here, even if you already got the template in place, you would click on Add Reveal Tab. And then the same thing as we've said before in other tutorials, you can look at the tutorial on Reveal Tab. You can add an image and a video if you would like. So let me add an image. All right, so I added this image in here. I'll scroll down and click Save. Now here's where it sometimes gets a little tricky, because if you're an admin of the page, you don't always see what it will look like inside Facebook. If I go over here and click on Refresh on this page, it may or may not show up. See, sorry, I've already liked the page, so this is why it's showing that. If I click unlike, and so I click unlike, and then you can see there how the reveal image shows up, or whatever image I put in for the reveal tab shows up here and hides the content underneath that. And then once I click on unlike, then that tab that we put in there, you know, will now show up inside here. You know, there you go, there's the template there that we created. So keep in mind that, you know, if you do want to use the reveal tab, you can use these in conjunction with the templates. You'll just need to add in whatever image or video you want, just like you would with any other module.